Megan Dwyer is live in Vernon Hills tonight with more on that. Megan?
Micah and Joe, these families are breathing a collective sigh of relief tonight. Many of them have been outspoken since the very beginning about murder charges here being unfair.
He's coming home today, and I just pray that my son really stay on a straight, narrow path and do what's right.
Her teenage son walked out of jail today. He and his cousins were facing 20 to 60 years in prison for their role in a stolen car joyride last month in Old Mill Creek.
Not knowing if my cousin was going to be alive or not, I prayed about everything from the beginning. And I see that he answered my prayer. I'm happy to be home and get the opportunity that I got to see sunlight again.
Police say the teens came to Lake County in a stolen car. They were trying to break into cars when they pulled into the wrong driveway.
Just teens being teens. I'm not going to point the finger.
The 75-year-old man who owned the home was asleep, but he woke up after seeing headlights. Fearing for his safety, he says he fired his gun, hoping to scare the teenagers, but one of the bullets hit 14-year-old Jaquan Swopes in the head and killed him.
It could have been all our kids. It could have been my son.
It's a lot, and it hurt.
Police chased the teenagers all the way back to Chicago, where they eventually ran out of gas. The Lake County State's attorney then charged them all with murder per the state's felony murder rule.
I do know that they did not kill Jaquan, so it was like we already burying one family member and had to fight for five more lives.
Today, the state's attorney downgraded the charges in the case after he had a chance to review all the evidence. While emotions are still raw for the mother of the 14-year-old,
they f***ed up and corrupt.
Others are thanking him for changing his mind.
He could have made us fight for years and could have easily, you know, took they life away, you know, through the system. So I really want to thank Mr. Nierheim for coming to an understanding with us.
Good. Happy to be home with my brothers and sisters.
Now, of all those teenagers there that night, only one of them is technically an adult, 18-year-old Diamond Davis. She was in bond court today. No longer is she facing murder charges, but she is expected to plead guilty to conspiracy to commit burglary and trespass to a motor vehicle. We are live tonight in Vernon Hills.